Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the leader of the United Labour Party, the one and only Ralph Horan, Ralph Gonsalves. Put your hands together and welcome the master, the leader, the general, the comrade, Dr. Ralph Gonsalves. Thank you. Good day.
Celebo Se comrade. Somebody say hit it.
Diaspora
and the rebel in me.
Peace and prosperity in the world
and the lovers we
unity
will bring sweet harmony,
hope
then it will bring
and
out
faith
love.
Bring out the love,
bring out all the love in us.
What a party, what a people, what a nation. Brothers and sisters in North Central, Windward, the comrades in the diaspora, New York, London, Toronto, all over St. Vincent and Grenadines. In Dominica, we thank Roosevelt Skerritt, my comrade and friend, the Dominica Labour Party and his dear wife. We thank them for coming to celebrate with us. The students at the University of the West Indies in Jamaica, in Barbados, in Trinidad, in Cuba, in Venezuela, in North America, in Europe, in Taiwan, you're hearing me. In Argentina, in Africa. Comrades and friends of labor, warriors of the Unity Labor Party, the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, whom I love dearly, and to whom and for whom I have dedicated my entire life of service. And I shall continue to do so until the good Lord comes for me. Until I leave the earthly city for the heavenly one. You can be assured, you are assured, and you will ever be assured that I am there with you. I love you. And when I look into your eyes, you know how I feel with you. When I touch you, you know how I feel.
Love means so many different things, but you're all that matters. This is all I'll ever ask of you. Baby, tell me your dreams so they can be mine too.
We have been together in the highs. We have been together on the mountaintop. We have been together in the valleys. We have been at times of difficulties. We have been at times when we experience weaknesses and limitations. But we are there always with our strengths and our possibilities to lift St. Vincent and the Grenadines higher.
Many rivers to cross, but I can't seem to find.
Many more rivers to cross.
Wandering, I am lost as I travel along white cliffs of Dover. Many rivers to cross.
Many rivers for us still to cross together in solidarity and in love and in hope.
That keeps me alive. For years.
Yes. And the good Lord has helped us.
Because of my pride.
We cannot be defeated. A united people in solidarity under the suzerainty of Almighty God in righteousness and for goodness, we will never be defeated. What does the Lord require of us? To do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with Him. We are not a party of anger. We are not a party of hatred. We are not a party of discord. We are a party of unity and of caring. And those who sometimes get frustrated and want to leave the family, I say, come home. Come home. Stay home. Let's stay together. The journey is not yet over. Come home. Let's be together. The beginning is to come home. The next is to stay together. And then to work together in success, in solidarity, for all our hopes and all our dreams and all that we desire in our families, in our individual lives, and in our nation.
I'm so in love with you. Whatever you want to do.
Let's reflect carefully.
It's all right with me.
No noise, no confusion, no botheration. Let's do it in peace and harmony. Comrades, as we begin tonight, I want to remember stalwarts. Some who have retired and some who have gone to the great beyond. We remember the very foundations of the Labour Party. Robert Milton Cato, Hudson Tannis, Arthur Williams, Grafton Isaacs, Randolph Russell, Tuffy Woods, and all the others, Hobbs Huggins, all those who laid the foundations of Labour. And Labour led this party to independence, this country to independence. We must never forget that it is the Labour Party under Milton Cato that led this country to independence. It is the NDP which opposed independence. It is Ebenezer Joshua, for all the good he did earlier, he opposed independence. It is the Unity Labour Party predecessor, the Labour Party, and ULIMO and UPM and the broad mass of people in this country who stood for independence. And you, recognizing that, the successor party, the Unity Labour Party, we have been in government now for more than half of the time that our country has been independent. We have built independent St. Vincent and the Grenadines. You know, Sir Vincent Beach, of blessed memory, we remember him. And recently, our comrade in Union Island, Yvette Bentick, went to the great beyond. She's burying, I believe, on Saturday the 1st of April. We extend condolences to her family, to her children and her grandchildren, and to the people of the Southern Grenadines, whom she served very well. And for all those who have been with us over the last 22 years, who have lost their loved ones, we remember you. And for those who are not here tonight because they are too ill, cannot move, we pray for you. We pray for your recovery. And we pray that Almighty God will take care of you in your sickness. And those who are in the prisons, I say to you, go on the straight and narrow when you get out. St. Vincent and the Grenadines also belongs to you, and there's hope for you, and there's love for you. You know, the book of Matthew, chapter 25, is very instructive. There are three parts to that great chapter. The first part is the parable of the five wise and the five foolish virgins. The lesson from that is that you must plan. Put a little oil in your lamp and keep it burning, because if you do that, you're always going to take advantage of the opportunities that come your way. Always. That's why we have the plan. Put a little oil in your lamp. Keep it burning. Put a little oil in your lamp.
Put oil in my lamp. Keep it burning. Oh, give me more oil in my lamp. I pray. Oh, give me more oil in my lamp. Keep it burning. Keep it burning till the praise.
Labor oil in your lamp. For progress.
Give me more oil in my lamp, I pray. Oh, give me more oil in my lamp. Keep it burning, I'm burning. Keep it burning till the break of
day. The second part of chapter 25 of the book of Matthew deals with talents. Each of us has talents. And what we have to do, we have to use our talents. You can't bury your talent. You can't bury your ability. You have to work. If you don't have a job today, you have to look for something to do. You have an ability, you have to train. Take advantage of the opportunities for training. Primary education, secondary education, technical education, college, university, and all the opportunities are there. Technical and vocational education, they are all there. Do not bury your talent. In this new world, in this new period of the evolution of the world civilization, of the global economy, you need a skill. Do not bury your talent. You bury your talent which the God has given to you, He will not be pleased. We have to take care of our families and be with our families in unity, and we have to take care especially of the young males. The mothers and fathers have to make sure, because before the state, before government came into existence, the family came. The family. And we have to make sure that the family is well supported, that we provide for the family the sustenance. But the government can't create good families. Those in the families have to do that so that we can deal better with this monster of crime that comes into the hearts, into the bosom, especially of a small minority of young males. Join the Cadet Corps. Join Pan Against Crime. The Police Youth Club. Join a football club, a cricket club, a community organization, in your church group, in your choir. Organize yourself and do something, and let us build this community better and stronger. You don't hear these positive messages elsewhere, you know. You don't hear them. And we have to take up our bed and we have to walk. But the third part of chapter 25 is the caring part. A very caring part. It says that if your brother or sister is hungry, we have to feed them. If they're old, we have to take care of them. If they're in the hospital and if they're sick, we have to look after them. And if they're in prison, we don't turn our back on them. We try to bring them on the straight and narrow so that we will have a wholesome society. And out of all the compromises that history and our circumstances have made us, we have to do our best to make a whole son and a whole daughter out of the compromises which history and circumstances.
Society in trouble. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Anytime the family fail, the backbone of any nation rests on the foundation of family.
You know, in 2020, we had a manifesto. I know many of you all have it. It says, Unity Labour Party, our vision with enduring labour love. Manifesto 2020, lifting SVG higher. And what we put inside of this manifesto is what we are carrying out, because you elected us to carry this out. I will speak about what the journey we have made since 2001. But I want to tell you about now and the future. A number of our comrades have rightly spoken about our achievements from 2001. And they have given you a glimpse as to what is there ahead. I want to speak in a little more detail. And when I'm here speaking to you, I want to tell you that I do not want to leave an unfinished task behind. Dear Lord, do not allow me, do not make me leave an unfinished task behind. And I need your help not to leave unfinished tasks behind. Let's not leave any unfinished tasks behind. Us leave behind an unfinished task. Labor.
Lord, here I find you run the race. You have paid everything.
We are running the race.
Amidst
all the challenges and difficulties, we must have love and hope and faith. You know, when I speak like that in the parliament, the opposition said, including one last parliament, this, he said, he shout across, he said, you go die in office, meaning I will die in office before the next election, as though he has control over that. I tell him, a lot of people wanted to see me in the cemetery before then, and I attend their funeral. Be careful, young man. But he ain't so young. He playing that he's a young man, but he ain't so young. But one thing I tell all of them, in the work which I'm going to talk to you about with Dwayne, the older the fiddle, the sweeter the tune. Emmanuel, you ain't got nothing for that one, eh? Eh, a stump you there, man. The older the fiddle, the sweeter the tune. And I will tell you this, heard melodies are sweet, but those unheard are sweeter. You ain't hear yet all which is sweet. There's many more sweet things to hear from the comrade, and many more things to be accomplished. Heard melodies are sweet, but those unheard are sweeter. Reminding you all the time, the older the fiddle, the sweeter the tune. Between 2022, that is last year, and 2026, because at the end of, towards the end of March 2026 is when the elections are constitutionally due at their outer limit, and between now and then, we in this government already have lined up nearly 3 billion, not million, you know, 3 billion Eastern Caribbean dollars worth of capital projects, which are over $1 million each. I ain't talking about those under a million. I only deal with those over a million. You check them up. We have the money lined up already. So what you're seeing taking place now, prepare yourself, get your skills, because the projects are rolling out, and this is only through the government. And I tell you this, I ain't even count yet this which I got from the Caribbean Development Bank, which is going to be launched on Tuesday. The Country Engagement Strategy 2022 to 2026. This is going to be, hear it, we are pleased to inform that the Board of Directors of the Caribbean Development Bank, at its 299th meeting held on the 22nd of September 2022, approved the Country Engagement Strategy 2022 to 2026 for St. Vincent and the Grenadines, with an indicative resource envelope of $88.4 million. The Country Engagement Strategy will support the implementation of the development agenda of the government of St. Vincent and the Grenadines in the areas of agriculture, private sector development, micro, small, and medium-sized enterprises, social protection, education, physical infrastructure development, energy and climate change resilience, and disaster risk management. You hear me? That is what is now in the offing beyond what I tell you about the public sector development programs. And I ain't talk yet about the nearly $1 billion in private sector development led by Sandals, which is $550 million. And the hotels at Royal Mill, and the hotel down at Mount Duane, and which is part involved with the private sector from Trinidad, and down at Peter's Hope. And people in the private sector, local private sector, like what we are seeing building hotels and apartments all over St. Vincent and the Grenadines. It is an incredible thing which is happening in St. Vincent and the Grenadines to create wealth, to create jobs, and to lift St. Vincent and the Grenadines higher.
Never lost my way, never turned fool when I reach out the crossroad. Never lost my way, never see the hype and get confused.
You know they are happening. Some of them are happening right now before your very eyes. The $650 million project at the port. Right here. Sometime after October, right here where we are. This place is going to be a construction site. For a $200 million acute referral hospital, top of the line hospital. For the people of St. Vincent and Grenadines. Right
when
here.
You're wrapped up in my arms, dancing to a reggae song. Feel good, feel good.
And we ain't talking yet about the private public sector development in relation to the build out of this city at Arnesville, which is going to be hundreds of millions of dollars between the government and the private sector, local and foreign. And then, when we move the port, when we finish the port down in Bottom Tongue in June 2025, the land where the old port is in Kingston is going to be available for development. We are going to put a wellness set of facilities there. We're going to put cultural and artistic hubs there, a main one. We're going to put another cruise ship pier there. I've already taken persons to deal with the matter of investments with the government. We intend to put the money in, the land in, as equity, and let the people bring developmental money. That is how we want to do these things for St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Do not let me leave behind any unfinished tasks.
Made a lot of bad moves.
The speakers before told you about the journey we have traveled. And if you wanted to know when you contest a government, is when there are difficulties. And we have faced difficulties repeatedly over this period. Repeatedly. And I tell you, the big ones, COVID, and the one, the volcanic eruption. Now, it's only a few, 2 years since then that has happened. 2 years since COVID. Last year, a year and a half since the volcanic eruption. And you wouldn't believe that those things happened in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. The houses are going back up. We are doing more and more with that. We are building more schools. We are building the health centers, clinics. We're doing matters in the field of culture and sports. All of these, in every single area of public sector activity, our plans are laid out. And if you want to find out even more, this is the last book which I wrote. Published in September, call it Time of Respair. Beyond COVID, volcanic eruptions, Hurricane Elsa, global turmoil, fresh hope for St. Vincent and the Grenadines. We are on an upward trajectory. What are you going to do? You're going to change this party, which has done so much for this country, brought you from almost the depths of underdevelopment to progress in our country? Anybody seriously think that people who are full with anger and bile and confusion, like they have them on the NDP, hatred, you think they could run country?
You don't understand, oh girl.
They have anybody who could run the soul of the government, that is to say, national mobilization, social development, like Orlando Brewster. They have anybody who can run education, the man who was principal headmaster of the grammar school, like Curtis King. Anybody they have, like Sabi, to run agriculture, fisheries, and rural development. Like Jimmy for tourism, for health and wellness. Camilo in the Ministry of Finance and Economic Planning. The humble African in relation to the youth and the sports and the culture and the civil service. And KMP in the case of foreign affairs and foreign trade. And in the man who is running the airport, civil aviation, the man who is dealing with tourism and culture, Carlos James from North Leeward. And this, Gomery says that this will be his last term, but he'd always be there to guide us in matters of which he has so much knowledge. Not only our route, but in transport and works. And we pray for the recovery of Comrade Julian and new persons who will be coming on, whom you will help to bring on for the new government under the Unity Labour Party after we go to the elections the next time. projects I talk to you about, all of them are inside of this book. You see this book? I got this book next to me. Every single day. And I also got this book next to me. I got these two books next to me. And this one, where we are dealing with matters here on the earthly city, it has all the projects. All of them. Their state of preparation, all the funding arrangements, where they are, what else we need to do to push them better, everything is here. That is how we do our work. We have a plan, and we are following the plan in accordance with the principles outlined in our manifesto and the care in which I'm talking about. I want to say something tonight to those teachers and public servants who did not take the vaccine. I want them to know, and it's a small group. For instance, in the case of the teachers, out of 2,200, 2,300 teachers, you have about 130 of them who didn't take the vaccine. Relatively small numbers compared to the 2,200, 2,300. But I want them to know that I love them and I value them. And as we appeal the judgment of one judge, and as we ask for a stay of execution of that judgment, while the appeal progresses, I want all of them to indicate that they are interested in coming back. A number of them, they are, some are not. We want them to come back. We will make the arrangements and you will not lose any of your benefits. We said that since July last year. Even before July last year. Don't be stubborn. Don't allow anybody to mislead you. You can come back while the case, the appeal still goes on. And if, in fact, we get the stay in the execution of the judgment. I know that many have come back. Over 50 have come back. And there are others who are interested in coming back. But some don't want to come back for reasons of theology. Some don't want to come back for reasons of politics. Some don't want to come back because they're working elsewhere and they're hoping to get a judgment so they could get paid for the time they weren't working. So they will double dip. And some of them genuinely feel they have a principle at stake. But I'm reaching out in love and unity to all of them. And I want them to know the position of the government. You know, we believe, we consider that the judgment was a wrong judgment. They made a lot of mistakes. And all I will say about the judgment is this. Woe to you, teachers of the law and the Pharisees. You clean the outside of the cup and dish, but inside they are full of greed and self-indulgence. First clean the inside of the cup and dish, and then the outside also will be clean. Those are not my words. Those are the amended words in the book of Matthew chapter 23, verse 25 and verse 26. I just want everyone to know that this government and this prime minister has no bad-mindedness, no malice, just love and caring. Now, It is important that when you have a government, when you have a party, you have a leader. Leadership is absolutely important. And you know, and I know, that Friday too cold, Friday too aloof, Friday too disconnected, Friday is easily manipulated by a few people like a kind of puppet, thank you. Where the group their name? Where? The kings and queens. Yes. Them say jump Friday, say how high? That is what you want as a leader. You want somebody who you want the party at the height of the pandemic. They said, remember this, in April, early April, when we went to Parliament for monies to deal with the pandemic, you know what they said? Lock it down tight. Use draconian Chinese methods. Lock you up in your house. Quarantine you there. Lock the country down. Declare a state of emergency. People would eat people. And everywhere they try that, when they open back, a lot of people dead. When you had a family in Greggs with three people who got COVID, the leadership of the NDP said, quarantine Greggs, lock down Greggs. We said no. We send people inside there and we dealt with the problem sensibly and in a proportionate manner. One of the reasons why we have to appeal is simply this. If that judgment is allowed to stand, hear me and hear me well, and we have another pandemic, the only alternative which will remain is to let the pandemic rip and kill men, women, and children willy-nilly. I am not prepared to do that. We set out to save lives and livelihoods, and our consciences are clear because that is what we accomplished. You know, one of the amazing things, they put the country, the NDP put the country through nearly 4 years of turmoil after 2015. Say the elections in 2015 were stolen. All kind of ruses. Every single day, the leadership of the NDP and their fellow travelers harassing the supervisor of elections, threatening her. And then towards the end, they lose the case. They file an appeal, but they didn't carry forward with the appeal. They continue to behave as though they have an appeal. The election came, and that was the end of the matter. The new election came. This time again, they want to use the case of the teachers and the small group of public servants who did not take the vaccine. They want to use that as a battering ram against the government. When they knew that what they were arguing, and James Mitchell has said it, James Mitchell said that I was moving too slow, I should move firmer. All these are matters of record, you know. But as Oranda says, you know, when you go to a salad bar, if they have offering tomatoes, you take that. Cabbage, lettuce. You just hop on and you take anything. They're generating a complaints industry. You don't run a country like that. A complaints industry does not a government make. And they still can't get it in their head that they behave greedy and worthless and terrible in 2020. That is why the people came out on the streets and demonstrated in their thousands and said they want fresh elections. In this current situation, you notice I am telling them to come home. You notice how we're doing it. A different way altogether, and I hold no malice whatsoever. But they must not allow the NDP and a handful of internet crazies to lead them astray. This is a matter which, as a civilized people, I am sure that we will all work out properly within the legal framework through the appeal process. And I tell you this, if the government gets this day and we win the appeal, I will still make sure that they get their benefits, but I have to put the matter clearly as to what represents the law in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Now, I want to say to the people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines that last year, a small handful of young males caused a lot of problems with violence in this country. And the new year started as though they were carrying on. But thank God, since February the 9th, which is now about 6 weeks, we haven't got anybody killed by any gun. One person got killed. Allegedly, one brother chopped up another one in some family dispute or whatever that is. I'm not sure what are the facts. I want the young men who are here, either who involve in guns and cocaine and who involve in serious criminal activity to bring violence onto people, there is no future in that. Put down your gun. Put down your gun. There are opportunities for you to make a decent living. You get opportunities, you have a skill. Listen to me, please, as though your father is speaking to you. And I am doing so in love. I repeat that all the time. What we have had over the last 6-7 weeks, let us have that peace reigning. Let the peace reign in our beloved country. But it begins with you and inside of the families. And we will provide the supports. Never in the history of this country that you see a government borrowing money so that poor people could get a bank yard to get money. And then some, when we say, well, this was only a period of time, you can't quarrel with me when I tell you after the 6 months or the 8 months when you get the card that you use the money and you go and take out a stove. You cost me that you ain't got no more money to pay for the stove. You have to organize your affairs in a manner which is reasonable. You understand what I'm saying? I know that for some things are difficult. But there are opportunities. And we are in a far better place today than we ever were in the history of this country. You know that, and I know that. We are taking care of thousands upon thousands of people. I know some of you are saying in your head, some I get, but me not get. I don't want you to have that attitude. Go to the social development and make the arrangements to get help, because help is there for you if you have some difficulty. But develop your skill. Now, one of the things that I have observed in human civilization, and I've studied the issue historically and philosophically, by and large, human beings live in a condition of permanent dissatisfaction. If you come from there to here, and your necessary and desirable needs and wants are taken care of, when you reach here, it doesn't mean that you don't have some dissatisfaction still, because you want to reach there for you and your family. But you have to remember that you came from here, you reach here, and you can work with the Unity Labour Party government to get you there. For that, you need to have understanding. And you need to be able to appreciate all the difficulties which exist in a small country like this. And we have to work together. In order to help with that understanding, you have to reflect properly. And you have to study. And one of the weaknesses of the Unity Labour Party is that we haven't put aside enough effort to carry out as deep political education that we should have done. We spend a lot of time in government dealing with the problems, but not dealing enough with the education politically of the people. Tonight I'm announcing, and we will launch it formally. We are launching a Caribbean and Latin American Institute of Government and Politics as the principal educational arm of the Unity Labour Party. I will be the chairman of the board of that body, and Augustine Ferdinand will be the director. And we will be carrying out political education all over St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and on all the various media platforms, so that you will have a greater understanding about how things are happening and how we are evolving and how better days are ahead. For the persons who got their houses damaged by Sufre, I want to say to you, we are working assiduously building houses and repairing. Originally, we thought the number was going to be 653 when the estimate was done. It's over 2,000 now. And we are moving to them rapidly. And within the next couple of weeks, houses, the first set of houses of the 50 coming from Guyana. And we are going to be building more and more houses. And we're repairing more and more. And we have more and more money allocated. And we are making sure that those persons are taken care of. Some others will send for information, send for materials. Just bear with me until I deal comprehensively. And Orando deals comprehensively with all those who have suffered during the volcanic eruption. We have to be our brother's keepers. On this dangerous road to Jericho, Each of us is our neighbor. Each of us on this dangerous road to Jericho is our neighbor. Never mind some of the Levites. Never mind some of the lawyers. Never mind some of the prelates who pass on the dangerous road to Jericho and leave the wounded brother. You hear me? We have to reach out for that wounded brother, that wounded sister, and bind up the wounds and help to take care. That is the love of the Unity Labour Party. That is the heart and soul of what this government is about. Not hatred. You know, people said to me, what about the person who threw the object and bust my head? I pity that person and I forgive that person. But up to now, Friday hasn't said that what happened was a terrible thing. In fact, he said that the people did not behave in any way illegal. So busting my head is a perfectly legal thing. You hear me? There is too much hatred in that party. I can understand that if you're in opposition for 22 years and you have another 3 years going for 25, and people like Leacock start in their 50s and Cummins, and they're now in their 70s and Friday knocking his head up when by the 2025, 70 years old. They're frustrated. Deeply frustrated. But don't take it out on me. Don't hate me where you're hating me for. I don't have one hatred for anybody. None whatsoever. I am not made like that. This country is small. We have to live in it and we have to look out for one another and take care of everybody who on the dangerous road to Jericho.
The Prince of Darkness walks behind me.
Behind me.
But he will never, 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 never control me.
I want to say something about some comrades in the party. Some comrades in the party, as soon as they don't get something, they go on social media. You hear me? I am urging you to desist from doing that. There are one or two feel in the various areas that them are Samson. But you know what Samson did, you know, is bring the temple down on everybody's head, including your own. And one of the problems with some, the way they're behaving, that if we were to have an election and by some miracle the NDP win, the next morning, oh God, if I didn't know. If you didn't know, you better know now. You better know now. You're not a Samson. Nobody in the party is a Samson. We are brothers and sisters. We are comrades. And we have to work with one another. And when you get a little disappointment, do not turn it into anger. Do not turn it into vengeance. Because even when you come back home, you would have caused some damage to yourself, to your family, and to the party. People in the community, don't do that, please.
But don't you remember? Don't you remember?
22 years of excellent governance. That's what we are celebrating. But although we celebrate that, I have to give you where the vision is. To build a modern, competitive, many-sided, post-colonial economy, which is at once national, regional, and global, within the interests of the people. To have a foreign policy dealing with the dangerous external world, so that we can take care of our own humanization. In every material particular, to make sure that the state, the government, assist you. But remember this, you have your own individual responsibility. You have responsibility to yourself and to your family and to your community. And the government is there to help and put things in place. But you also have to help yourself. And you have to get training. You have to take advantage of the opportunities of Prime in business. Take advantage about the airport and the port and all the infrastructure developments to help make St. Vincent and the Grenadines a better place. Tonight, thus far, has been a wonderful night. I was reading an article by a professor a few days ago, and I want Friday them to hear this. When you have a man who is positive, this woman is 53 years old, and she has done research and she finds that positive people in their head feel that they're 20% younger. You hear me? She feels that she's 36, 37. She's a professor. Studied the phenomenon all over the world. Well, I standing up here, I feel 20% younger in my head. The brain in my head is young and it's turning over ideas. And I'm approaching 60 in my head. Eloise, tell me I'm a little younger than that. The point I'm making is this. I am here to serve you and to tell you that in addition to having ambitions for you, in addition to having ambitions for you and for the region and for the world, at a personal level, the following are my remaining ambitions. Personally, that at the moment of my death, I have no more sins to confess. At the moment of my death, I must have no enemies. You can have me as an enemy, but I wouldn't have you as an enemy. At the moment of my death, I must own nothing. And at the moment of my death, I must not leave behind any unfinished task. Happy 22nd anniversary, Unity Labour Party government. Thank you for coming out in your thousands upon thousands. And may Almighty God continue to bless all of us in love and in solidarity, in hope and in faith. I run the country and this woman run me. Don't take that too literally.
I see you on the streets some other time.
Oh yes. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
In the 22 years. We have a record in this Caribbean. In 22 years, I have never had cause to fire one single minister. In 22 years, no minister has ever any cause to resign from the government. Because there's love and unity. And we are on the same page with our manifestos and our ideas. And we are a family, a labor family. If today is not for you, put your pot on the fire that tomorrow is for you. And have a patience and a calm, knowing that sun brightens stone and all the river burns. Remember, the older the fiddle, the sweeter the tune. Heard melodies are sweet, but those unheard are sweeter. What a government, as Vincent Beach used to say. What a crowd of people. I can't even count the numbers. Snaggy tell me 17,000, so I can't dispute him. We have Skinny and Nyla and Fireman and others. And remember, we have Skinny and Nyla. For those who left us or thinking of leaving, come home. Come home. Remember, come to the family. Stay in the family. Look into my eyes.
Music, music, music.
You see what you mean to me? Labor in celebration style. Oh yes, oh yes.
You can't tell me it's not worth dying for.
You know it's true.
You know it's true.
Everything I do, everything we do it for you and with you. Look into my eyes, baby. Look into my eyes. Oh, yes. Take my life. I give my life to you. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, labor love. Ah, we are happy to have Roosevelt Skerritt and his magnificent wife. He represents the best of our Caribbean civilization. In 2025, when the good Lord answers me and we call the election, speak, Lord, your servant Ralph is listening. And when we go to the poll, 6 in a row, licks like bees, 6 in a row. As young Samuel asked in the presence of Eli, speak, Lord,
speak, Lord.
Your servant Ralph
servant
is listening. God bless you. Thank you very much. You know it's true. And let's enjoy the rest of the program. Thank you very much.
What a time.
Thank you very much.
What a night. What a night, what a night. One of those songs says, oh, what a night. Oh, what a night. Steven Sincere Horse, that is all right. I came here to be horse. Oh, what a night. Lance, M&M, before you proceed,